You are installing programs completely wrong. You're gonna ruin everything. Not really, but there are some things that you should consider when you go to install a program that you might not be, instead of just downloading it and clicking through the options as fast as possible. Because there are some security and convenience implications that you might not have thought of, including whether or not you should install for all users or just you, and even whether or not you should actually install the program using the Microsoft Store. Yes, I know, hear me out, because it might actually be the best option depending on the circumstance, and you might actually be surprised. So let's get into it. Now, I've already talked in the past about making the choice between installing for all users versus just you and what that actually means. And the simple explanation is usually that just makes it determine whether or not the program is installed into the program files folder or the app data folder. And the difference is that program files is only writable when you're escalated. You click that UAC prompt to allow admin access briefly while it installs the program to be able to change it, whereas you don't have to do that for app data. Apps can just write to it, read to it whenever it needs, so you don't have to get that prompt. And I would say when you have the choice, you should usually actually install for all users, even if you're the only user on the account. And that is because the app data folder is really just kind of shoved together. Any app can access it and write to it, but not only that, they can also write to any other app data folder created by anything else. Now, this is not really a problem if it's just some basic configuration data and stuff, but when you get to the point where entire programs are installed in there and you're potentially trusting these programs and running them, that could mean that malware could go in and modify the programs you're running themselves. And that could open the door for things like DLL hijacking, where malware will replace one of the DLLs that a legitimate application will run and then get it to run nasty stuff. Or it could just completely replace the application's exe entirely, and that is all without having to ever escalate to admin. Whereas if you install it for all users, which makes it go into the program files, you do need access to write to it. Now, to be clear, that doesn't mean that every time you then go and run the app, it's gonna run as admin. No, it'll still run as user. It's just if you ever want to go in and change that, for example, update the program, you will just have to click the UAC prompt to accept that change. So it's not really a big deal. I will point out though that some applications like Google Chrome and other browsers, even though they're installed in the program files directory, they don't actually require escalating as admin. You might have noticed you never get a UAC prompt when updating it. And that's because they actually do install initially a service that will auto update, and that stays running as admin in the background. And that way it handles the update, so you don't have to do a prompt every time. Not every app is set up like that though. And nor would you necessarily want every app to do that. Another thing I'll point out is some apps might not even give you the option by default to install for all users. For example, VS Code, it just installs into the app data folder. And if you want to install for all users, you actually have to download a separate installer, the system installer, they call it, from the download page, and then it will install into program files. And again, the only difference after that is you just have to click the thing to approve the update every time, and it's really not that big a deal, and it's more secure. Now, before I get into why sometimes the Microsoft Store is actually the better option, something else that you should secure is all your personal info online, which is where today's sponsor comes in, DeleteMe, a data privacy service to which I myself have been a paying customer for over 4 years now, from before they ever even sponsored. If you've ever Googled yourself, you definitely have seen the countless so-called data broker websites who not only collect and display all your personal information, like name, address, and phone number, but then also sell it to companies and other sketchy people to do whatever they want with it. This also makes it easier for malicious people to find and use your own personal info against you in phishing attacks, identity theft, harassment, and more. But that's where DeleteMe comes in. They do the work for you in submitting removal requests on your behalf. As new data brokers pop up, they're constantly adding new ones that they remove from, and when you sign up, you get a privacy report showing exactly which sites you were removed from after 7 days and every 3 months after that. You can even submit custom requests to remove your data from hundreds of other sites, and an expert will handle it for you. This includes some surprising sites like berkeley.edu and certain government sites, so not purely just data brokers. Plus, they have other useful privacy tools like email masking and phone number masking for US users. So if you want to get your personal information removed from the web and search results, go to joindeleteme.com/TheoJo or scan the QR code and use the promo code TheoJo for 20% off all consumer plans. And with all that being said, Let's continue. Now, next up, let's talk about apps from the Microsoft Store, because these are actually installed very differently than regular apps. And actually, many times, there's a major security advantage to installing it from the Microsoft Store. And that's because a lot of Microsoft Store apps, it used to be all of them, but not so much anymore. Many of the apps you install through the Microsoft Store are UWP apps, Universal Windows Platform. And these types of apps are run in what's called an app container, which just kind of sandboxes it. And this is different from like the Windows sandbox. It doesn't look any different from any other app you run, but it's very much isolated from the rest of the system and can't just go make changes all over the system without registering as requiring that permission when the developer goes to register that app and upload it to the Microsoft Store. It's a lot like when you install a phone app, those are very much locked down and only can do certain things they say they're gonna do. By default, phone apps can't just access everything else on the phone. However, a big thing you need to be aware of is in the Microsoft Store under the permissions, be on the lookout for any app that says this app can, and then it'll say, use all system resources. That's not necessarily a malicious thing or anything, but that basically means it's not really going to be sandboxed. It'll just have the same permissions as any other regular app running. It'll be able to do whatever it wants. So if you trust the app still, that's not a problem. Most apps that you install and download from the internet do that. But if you're specifically looking to install it from the Microsoft Store, thinking it'll be sandboxed and isolated, just know that that means it's kind of not going to be. Now, the app still might default to using the isolated APIs, so it'll still kind of keep everything containerized and centralized, so it's still easy to remove. But if you're specifically looking to make it so it doesn't have permission to do anything, that is not going to really be the case. Now, if an app you see is sandboxed, meaning it doesn't have that thing saying it'll use all permissions, then it's a bit different. For example, any of the UWP apps, instead of just writing to the app data folder and being able to access everything, they're going to get their own special config folder, which is still located in the app data local folder. But what's different is it will only be able to access that special folder for it, and other UWP apps won't be able to access it, and it won't be able to access other UWP apps special folders. Also, if an app wants to make changes to the registry, it doesn't do it directly. It actually gets basically its own special registry.dat hive file and writes to that. And then Windows transparently behind the scenes kind of merges it with the real registry. And it does this on the fly. So if you ever go and want to undo anything that the app did, you just delete its own registry file. So it's not like it makes permanent changes to the registry. So practically speaking, the positive thing with all that is it's a lot easier to know when you go to uninstall the program that everything actually was removed and it didn't leave any like leftover crap around. Now, again, there are additional permissions it can have, like if you go and save a file using the app, obviously it's not going to delete anything you ever save from the app. It's only going to be like config app data stuff. And going back to that one point that I touched on before, even if it is a app that does get access to all system resources, it does still get one of those special config folders. So it might still use that even if it does have access to the rest of the system. So it's still possibly more likely that it'll be easier to remove. Just be aware that if it really wants to, it can do whatever it wants. So obviously you still got to use some common sense in what you actually trust when you install. Now, in my opinion, probably the biggest advantage to installing something through the Microsoft Store, assuming it's an actual UWP app, is that it will update itself. And you could tell whether or not it's actually a UWP app is if you look at it and it does not say that it was provided and updated by something else. For example, if you search VLC Media Player, there's actually two different versions of it, both made by the official developer, but one is the UWP one and the other is like the classic one that you could just download and install. And the classic one is a Win32 app, it's called. It's a regular old Windows program. But that means that it does not actually get updated from the Microsoft Store itself. It just does its updating the way it normally would, where it might notify you when you run the app, hey, there's an update available, or you might have to manually download it yourself. Whereas if you were to download the UWP version, then it would actually just auto-update along with the Microsoft Store. It would keep it up to date. But one thing to be aware is a lot of times the UWP version of an app, if there is one, might not have as many features. And that's because if they want to be truly containerized and proper, then it's harder to interact with the rest of the system. So they might not be able to do as much. So just be aware that it might not be exactly the same. One thing I do want to mention though, is when you do install through the Microsoft App Store, it gets similar permissions, actually more so for the protections of the program files than even just the program files folder. It actually goes into a C program files Windows app directory, and you can't even view that as a user. Anything installed through the Microsoft Store gets like super extra permissions restricted on what can mess with those files. Basically, only the Microsoft Store can do that. So in terms of the application's binaries and stuff themselves, those will be probably even more protected than they would even being in program files. But again, like the config and user data and stuff, that won't be protected. That could still be just viewed by any malware. Apparently, I have read that Microsoft is working on something called Win32 app isolation, which will make it so that even regular Win32 apps, like I mentioned, will also be able to be run within an isolated container. Though from what I've been reading, it kind of makes it seem like it's going to be an opt-in thing and the developer has to add support for it, which for me, if that's true and there's no way to actually force an app into isolation, that would kind of defeat the purpose, because obviously any malware is not going to choose to isolate itself. It's just going to be normal. So I really hope they add a way to force apps to do that. Otherwise, for me, it'll kind of be pointless. That feature is still in the future, though, so I'll reserve judgment until it's actually out. And I have to imagine that they would want to add a feature like that. It would kind of be like a holy grail of security to be able to force apps to be isolated and not really have any side effects. Of course, that is the big challenge. And I would be curious to know whether or not you usually install for all users or just you, and maybe you have a reason for it. And also, maybe you'll start considering the Microsoft Store if you didn't really think about it before. So we can talk about all that down in the comments. Thanks again to DeleteMe for sponsoring. And again, if you want to have your personal info removed from data brokers, go to joindeleteme.com/TheoJo and use the promo code TheoJo for a discount. Now, if you want to keep watching, here's another relevant video where I went over more details about the difference between program files, the program data folder, which I didn't even get into this video, and app data, stuff like that. So I'll put that link right there you can click on. And of course, if you want to subscribe, I try to make videos about twice a week, so it should be worth it. And if you enjoyed the video, give it a big thumbs up. So thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.